a million reasons to hesitate for the history that's filled with hate. Have we ever been United States? I wonder. So who can blame us for the doubt? Forgive me if I think out loud, but when justice just won't come around, you wonder. I was born with two dirty hands. Something my daddy didn't understand. Something his daddy didn't understand. So it starts with me.
This is how I create my OB Dragon Blood Peacocks. I take a aggressive OB male like this one here in the video. Provide him with plenty of female Dragon Bloods. Two different places to spawn. One on the left and one on the far right. You can replicate spawning areas like this one on the left with two rocks and a flat stone above, or with simple terracotta pots on your far right, changing them up every month or once a week will definitely increase your odds in more spawning activity. Increasing your water temperature to 80 degrees will greatly help increase the chances of productivity in the spawning process. Adequate water changes and good filtration will also aid in the spawning process. Generally, a rule of thumb when you're trying to get cichlids to spawn is one male to 5 to 8 females. In this Dragon Blood and OB tank, there is roughly 12 females to one male. You can increase his productivity even more by adding a smaller subdominant male in with this group. As you can see the female back there, he has spawned with earlier today and continues to spawn with her today until she is no longer producing eggs. There's a couple albino females in here, one being right there. There's another one just coming into the film. As your male keeps all the females to one side, he will then start spawning again with the female. Right there is the spawning process. She's dropping eggs and he is coming along fertilizing them. This male took a while, so definitely give it time. But eventually, the breeding process will happen.